The Human Rights Commission has been holding public consultations with Pacific communities in recent weeks to hear what the human rights priorities and issues are for their families. Some of those issues include violence against women and children, access to bank loans and elder abuse. So here to shed more light on these matters is the Commissioner responsible for Pasifika and the Rainbow Community, Saunoamaali'i Dr. Karanina Sumeo. Good morning. Thanks for coming on the show today. So tell me about these consultations. What was the response like from the Pacific community and what were the issues that they raised?
Well, mālo lele, e talo falava. So the Human Rights Commission has this vision for our role, which is a dignified life for all. And it's really important that Pacific people define to us, you know, what does a dignified look like, you know? And so the consultations was an opportunity for the Pacific to, for Pacific peoples to help us define those priorities and, you know, tell us what matters to them from a human rights perspective. I heard you earlier talking about the Dawn Raids. Now, if we think about the Dawn Raids, that was probably one of the biggest examples of violations of human rights of Pacific people, you know, enforced by the state and so forth. Perhaps in those times, perhaps we didn't recognise it as a violation of human rights, but that is a classic example of violation of human rights. So it's really important that going forward for New Zealand, that Pacific people have a space in defining what are human rights. So if we talk about a dignified right for all, so in these community consultations, so we had whānau in Auckland, we had whānau in Wellington, we had whānau with older peoples, we had whānau with rainbow peoples, rainbow communities.
Was it a good turnout?
It was a good turnout in Aokilangi, Auckland and Wellington. Christchurch, we had a whānau and nobody turned up.
Wow.
And you know what? That's a lesson for us.
Right.
Because does that mean, are we not reaching them? Are we not communicating? Or are they not noticing our communities not identifying the relevance of the commission to their lives?
It's really so important that they
really
engage
important.
In these discussions.
Absolutely.
Because
Absolutely.
At the end of these consultations, what's going to happen? How is that going to bring change for our Pacific community?
Absolutely. So some of the significant issues that they've raised, they talked about hardship. Our children living in poverty, worrying about the poverty, worrying about the power bill, you know, clothing. In human rights language, that's called, you know, that's called lacking really an adequate standard of living. So for us, those are really, those are human rights issues. If we're talking about life of dignity, we're talking about our children not fearing that they're going to get whacked, you know, for whatever. We're talking about our women and our mothers not fearing that they're going to get, you know, beaten up
domestic
at home.
Violence.
Yeah, we're talking about our young, older people being able to grow old in dignity, surrounded by their families.
So these are the kind of issues that were raised in the public consultation.
Absolutely.
Now, can you tell me, because the Human Rights Commission is in the middle of drafting this paper called Talanoa, but it's the first of its kind. What is this about and how important is it for our Pacific community?
Yeah. So the Talanoa paper, that work has been led by Tulomanjori Samu, she's our Pacific advisor, and that is really collecting all this information from our people and feeding into the priorities for the Human Rights Commission. We're talking about the Human Rights Commission advocacy for the next 5 years or so. So when our strategy comes out, we want Pacific people to see their interests reflected in there because it hasn't been reflected in there in the past. So it's a great opportunity for our people, from our young to our old, to our, you know, to our women suffering low pay in the public sector and so forth. So it's very important.
And one of the focuses of that paper is going to look at structural racism and unconscious bias. So there's some big terms that I think sometimes in the Pacific community, people are like, what does that look like? Can you break that down in everyday life for Pasifika? What do those two terms look like?
Okay. So let's look at structural racism first. So let's take the issue of low pay. So we've known for at least 10 years that in the public service, Pacific women have been have received the lowest income compared to other women in other groups and men as well. That's a problem that we've known for 10 years. It's not a one-off issue. So that can be seen as structural racism. There are issues in the way we structure our employment, the way we recruit people, the way we advance people moving up the ranks that is disadvantaging Pacific women. So that can be considered a form of structural racism. If we think about unconscious bias, so unconscious bias, I think we all have unconscious bias. The things that, you know, we react to situations, to people, possibly based on the stereotypes that we have about them. And, you know, our people talk about the stereotypes that have been you know, imposed upon them. So our young people talk about being in school where the teacher expectation isn't very high on them because they think you're Pacific, I can't expect. That is what I call unconscious bias. There are people like, say, our women who want, you know, who apply for jobs, and our men apply for jobs, but somehow not quite the right fit to get that management role.
Right, yeah.
Unconscious bias has a role in there. So what research says is that we can probably explain where people are in their pay based on qualifications and experience, etc., but the bulk of it is down to unconscious bias.
Right.
So it has a role in disadvantaging our people.
It's really interesting and crucial for our community to understand exactly what that looks like. So then you can move on forward after these consultations and hopefully we can see some change. Thank you so much, Saunoamaali'i, for joining us this morning.
Mālama.